Hello everyone, welcome to this video lesson. In this video lesson, we would like to derive Ohm's law in a vector format using the concept of a drift velocity. We have derived an equation for the drift velocity in the previous case. Drift velocity is the constant velocity acquired by an electron when it is moving in a say, conducting material. We have proved that drift velocity Vd equal to the current passing in the conductor I by A area of cross section, E is the charge of electron and N is the number of electrons per unit volume. We have derived this equation. But we know current per unit area of cross section is called current density, shown with the letter J. So I can write drift velocity is, in the place of this I by A, I can write J, E and N. So the current density J can be written like drift velocity into N into number of electrons per unit volume into charge of an electron. This is the equation. But we know when an electron is passing in a say conducting material, you will get some drift velocity during a relaxation time, that is before the collision. We can write that formula as V equal to U plus AT. Electron has got that acceleration because you have applied some external electric field. Being electron is an opposite charge, it moves against the external field. Its initial velocity is 0. Acceleration is EQ by M because you know F equal to EQ. It will experience a force that is equal to ma. So electron is under an acceleration of eq by m. Time is called something like relaxation time. Hence we know the equation for the drift velocity as e the relaxation time into mass of electron by charge of electron. Let me show the charge of electron with the e itself. So we know the equation for drift velocity. We will substitute this value in the current density equation. We know that the, basing on the drift velocity definition, current density J is equal to, we have written here, number of electrons per unit volume, charge of electron into drift velocity. So number of electrons per unit volume, charge of electron, in the place of drift velocity, I can substitute this value. Electric field intensity into relaxation time by mass into charge of electron. So it can be rewritten as N E square relaxation time into mass by electric intensity is surface charge density, current surface charge density. You can see all these terms are constants. Number of electrons per unit volume is constant for a given metal. Charge of electron is constant, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Relaxation time is constant, depends on that conducting material nature. Mass of electron is constant. All that proportionality constants together is called something like conductivity. How well the current is passing in a given conductor, shown with a letter something like sigma. So we can write that equation J as sigma into E, where J is current density, sigma is current conductivity, E is electric field intensity. This law is called something like Ohm's law. I know you feel like this is not the law that we know as a Ohm's law, not a familiar law that we know. We will try, say, rewriting that Ohm's law so that you can get the format that you know. Current density is sigma into E. Current density can be written like I by A, sigma. You know, whenever electric potential is applied, there is a relation between electric potential and electric intensity, E into D. We have derived this in the previous chapter of electric potential. Say here, D is the distance through which the electron has passed. It has now passed through the length of the conductor. That's nothing but equal to L itself. Basing on this, you can write E as something like V by L. Substituting all these values in the place of E, I can write V by L. So you can write an equation for electric potential V is equal to I by A into L by sigma. We know 1 by sigma reciprocal of conductivity. Reciprocal of conductivity is called resistivity, opposition to the flow of the current, also called as to be specific resistance, shown with the letter rho. So you can rewrite the terms like V is equal to, from this equation, I by A into L, 1 by conductivity is called resistivity. So you can rewrite your formula, V equal to rho L by A into I. Rho L by A is a constant for a given material, which is called as something like, we know the formula, distance of a material opposition to the flow of the current is directly proportional to length. More the length, more the resistance. Inversely proportional to the area of cross section. So R is nothing but equal to rho L by A. So this rho L by A nothing but is representing the resistance of the material. So you can write the formula as V is nothing but equal to I into R. This is a popular Ohm's law that you already familiar with, but this is another way of expressing Ohm's law, which we are getting basing on the drift velocity. This is how we can write Ohm's law in another format also, that the current density is conductivity into electric intensity. That's how we can get it right. Thank you for watching. Keep coming back for more and more video lessons. Thank you.